flow, and I miss my capoeira class.
I made this video that we can all practice till we see again. Come and join me!
Welcome to today's capoeira session. Before we start, here you see a few things that might be really helpful to have a fantastic, undisturbed capoeira session today. If you can't find them, don't worry at all. It will work without two. Alright, let's get ready and start with a warm-up. Check out your legs, check out your feet, loosen up. Check out your fingers and your arms, relax your shoulders. And balance on one leg and circle around with your foot. To the left and then to the right. Then you go up and down with your foot. And shift it to the side, left and right. Then to the front and to the back, bending and straightening your leg. And now the same thing on the other side. First around, then up and down. Then shifting your foot to the side. And back and forward with your leg, straightening and bending your knee. Good. Check out your legs again. Hands on your knees and bending and straightening both knees at the same time. Alright, hands to your hips, your feet about shoulder width apart, and bring your hip around. One way a couple of times, and then the other way around. Good job. Now turn your hips and throw your arms around. Loosen your arms, your hip is turning your torso to the left and to the right. And now we're gonna make circles with our knee from the inside to the outside, left and right. Now the same thing the other way around, from the outside to the inside, making circles with your knee. Okay, now you're gonna bring your hip forward, bring your hip out. Right. Now we're gonna add the knee again. So the knee goes up and forward. And your shoulders go back when your leg goes up. Just lean backwards with your shoulders and bring your knee forward. Now we bring the knee from the side. Knees to both sides, left and right. And the knee comes around from the side. Good. Jump up and down a little bit. Loosen up. Relax your shoulders. And now we're gonna lift up one arm and circle it to the front. Bring it around. Really fast if you can. And now we go backwards with the same arm. Same thing on the other side. Circling forward. And backwards. Alright, now both arms at the same time. Forward. Faster, faster. And backwards. As fast as you can. And jump up and down a little bit. Okay. Bring your arms across your chest and open them to the back. Good. Grab your elbow with one hand and bring your forearm around. First one way and then the other way. Same thing on the other side. And the other way around. Good, bring your hands together and twist your hands left and to the right. Good. Now bring your left ear to your left shoulder and the right ear to the right shoulder. Slow and easy. Now bring your chin to your chest and then look up to the ceiling. Up and down. Slow and easy. Now we look to the left, then to the right, turning our head. And then we do a semicircle with our head. Bring it around. Alright, you're gonna lift up your arms now and you're gonna prepare for the Jinga, the basic movement in capoeira. You jump from your left to your right foot and keep those elbows close to your upper body. Very good. Good job, Beja Flow. Jumping from left to right. Now you're putting back one leg. So if your left leg goes back, the left arm is up. If your right leg goes back, the right arm is up. And the arm that's up shouldn't be too far out. It should be right in front of your upper body. And it should cover your head and your upper body. And then we're gonna shift our weight from the front to the back and bounce back and forward a little bit. And the other arm is just loosely hanging down. And then we switch. Now the other leg goes back and we switch the arm as well. And nice and relaxed, shoulders are relaxed. And remember, the same side where your leg is back, that's where the arm is up, protecting your face. Job, loosen up a little bit, jumping. Just jump on the spot. And let's go, jumping jacks. And to the front. Lift your arms. jumping on the spot, and now up with the heels, up to your bottom. Kick up your heels, kick up those heels. Now up with the knees. Up to your hands with those knees. Up, 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 up. Good job. Keep on jumping, keep on bouncing. Little bit more, little more. Side to side now. Small jump. Back and forward. Good job. Take a breath, loosen up. And now we're gonna work on the Jinga. First, the leg movement. Your feet are apart, side by side, and then you're gonna make one step back. First with the leg, with the left, then with your right leg. It's like walking on a triangle. There's three spots on the ground. Two in front and one is in the back. One leg goes back and comes forward again. Back and forward. Good. Look straight ahead. Your toes should always point forward. And the arms are loosely hanging down by your sides. Alright, stop for a second. Left leg back, left arm is up. Now we're gonna bring the arms as well. Side by side, both arms are up. And now right leg back, right arm up. Then to the front, side by side, two arms up. And switch again. Slow and easy, step by step. Going into the Jinga. Now let's go a little faster. Swing those arms. And your knees should be slightly bent. And this is how it looks from the side. Bridge of course, upper body could lean forward a little more. Otherwise, she's doing a great job. Well done. Shake out your feet a little bit. Catch your breath. And lift up one arm. Lift up the two arms and reach for those apples on the tree. Stretch out, reach up, reach, reach. Pick the mango from the tree. And shake out your arms. Bring one arm across your chest. Hand on the elbow. And stretch out your shoulder. And look over the shoulder you're stretching. And the same on the other side. Lift up one arm, grab it with the other arm, and stretch your side. Same thing to the other side. Interlace your fingers, turn them out and stretch forward. Lift those arms up over your head. And lean back. Look up to the ceiling. Hands above your head and now to the side. And the other side. Show me your fingers. Good, and stretch out your hand and your arm. Fingers pointing down, and you grab all your fingers and pull them back. You should feel a stretch in your hand and your forearm. Check out those fingers. Alright, widen your stance a little bit. Keep your knees straight and touch your left foot with both hands. And down to the other side. Both hands to your right foot. If you can, go a little deeper. Good. And catch your foot and balance on one leg. Keep those knees side by side. And balance on one leg. Same thing on the other side. There you go. Keep your knees straight and see if you can touch the floor with your fingertips. Right in front of your toes. Keep those knees straight and see if you can put your flat hand on the ground. Can you reach? Try harder. Alright. Hands in your back and lean backwards one more time, looking up to the ceiling. Okay, basic techniques. Start with the Jinga. And we're going to start with a defensive movement. Called Cocorinha. So you can use that against attacks that come from the side. So from the Jinga position, put your feet side by side. And squat down. One arm is above your head and the other hand is flat on the ground. One more time on the other side. Feet are flat on the ground. And switch to the other side without getting up. Left and right. Switch your arm. Arm strong above your head. And back into the Jinga. Now we're going to do the Cocorinha. And go back into the Jinga. One to the left. And one to the right. Now we're switching. Cocorinha and switch your arm and back into the Jinga. Good job. Alright, next technique, an attack. Meia lua di frente. Right leg is back and bring your leg around from the outside to the inside. Straight knee and toes show up to the sky. 10 times on each side. And left leg now. Jing a few times just to catch your breath. And then we do 10 kicks with the left leg. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, last one, 10. Nice work. And jinga. Catch your breath while doing the jinga. Alright, now we're going to do one kick with the left, jinga one time, and the same kick with the right. So it's going to be one kick, then switch to the other side doing the jinga, and then the other side. Beja Flor is showing us from the side. It should be looking more or less like that. After each kick, you bring your leg back again, and then jinga. Good, check out your legs, check out your arms, loosen those shoulders, and we prepare for the next defense. Put both hands to the left and then to the right. Left and right. Now we're gonna add the leg. Same side, you put your hands to the side. You lift the leg up. Alright, let's squat down. Kokorinha, just like before. And now put both hands to the side and straighten your leg on the same side. Good job. Only two hands and one foot are touching the ground. The leg that's straight is above the ground and your bottom is above the ground too. Now bend those elbows and lower your head if you can. And we're gonna switch from side to side with this technique called Mega Chiva. Alright, loosen up your shoulders, shake out your legs. Jinga position, and our next attack called Benso, kick to the front. Raise your knee, and when you push out the leg, you pull back your hands, and your shoulders go back as well. When your leg goes forward, your shoulders go backward. 10 times to the right. And then 10 with the left leg. Left leg is back, left arm is up. Reach forward with your hands, knees up, and then pull back with your arms and push out your leg. 10 times again. Catch your breath in the jinga. And now we're going to do benzo on one side. Switch over to the other side, doing a jinga. And just like before, one kick to the left, jinga, one kick to the right. Lean back those shoulders when you kick forward. Well done. Good job. Jinga position. Right leg is back. Kishada Sota. That's a kick coming from the inside to the outside. And bring your leg up as high as you can, as that kick is aiming for the head. Start and finish in the same jinga position. Again, 10 times on each side. And one more time, jinga. Catching your breath. And then we're going to do the Kishada. Jinga one time and Kishada on the other side. Excellent job. Now let's move forward. We're going to start to work on our balance. And first, we are going to step by step learn how to do a handstand. So make a big step, put both hands on the floor, and jump up 10 times. One leg is going up and the other leg stays close to the ground. Put your chin to your chest and look at the wall behind you. Now the same thing on the other side. Jump up 10 times. Good job. Loosen up your legs a little bit. Now we're going to do the same thing from a starting from a standing position. So make a big step back again. Bend the front knee. Hands are up above your head. And now you're going to raise the back leg up. And the other leg goes up about halfway. So go down on your hands. And bring up one leg. Every time you come down, you switch. And remember to put your chin to your chest and look at the wall behind you. And if that feels good, the next step would be to bring up both legs. So instead of lifting only one leg when you're on your hands, you're gonna join the second leg and see if you can get the full handstand going. Always bend your knee when you're starting. And straighten those elbows. Straight arms when you go down. Okay, good job, Asia Floor. Join those legs and come into a full handstand. And when you come back down on the floor, remember, first one leg and then the other leg. So don't drop hard on the floor with both legs at the same time. Okay, squatting down to the floor now in Kedaji Quattro position. And show me one hand. And show me the other hand. Only your feet and your hands are touching the floor. Show me those. Show me the hand, left and right. Now stretch out one leg. One hand is up and the leg on the other side goes out. Okay, trust the legs right now. Left and right. We're gonna prepare for cartwheel. And you're gonna start nice and easy on the floor. So if you want to go to the left, you stretch out the left leg. If you want to go to the right, you stretch out the right leg. And now bring the other leg, loop between the legs and come around. Starting from the Kedaji Quattro position, one leg, arm is up, second leg, loop between the legs and pass the second leg. And then you can do it a little faster if you're feeling comfortable. And just roll from the left back to the right. Always looking in front of you. Now we're gonna do the same thing starting from a squatting position. Show me those hands. One hand, the other hand. First leg, look, and the second leg. So we're going to go in four times. That hand, hand, leg, leg, and back to the start position. Now go a little higher. Squat, but a little higher. High squat. One, two, three, four. Good job. Hand, hand, leg, look, and leg. Now we're going to do it from a standing position. You don't have to bring those legs up as yet. Do a cartwheel with the legs kind of low to the ground. Left and right, both sides. Alright, if that wasn't too difficult, now we're gonna do the full au, au coroado, or a full cartwheel. Now if that's too difficult, then just stick to the small one and do the one on the ground that we did before. Alright, good job. Check out your legs. Take a breath. And now we're adding back the jinga. So jinga. And we're gonna do a cartwheel starting from the jinga and we finish it in the jinga.
Sou cativeiro de valor, mas eu sou cativeiro.
Make sure you look in front of you while you're on your hands. And you fall right back into the jingle. Okay, now we're preparing for the bridge, the ponchi. If you have a mat, do it on a mat or on a carpet. Bring the hip up and lift your heels off the ground as well. Try to look behind you, or at least to the side. Up with the hip. Okay, make your back round, stretch forward. And now you're gonna lie down on your back, put your hands on your shoulders, heels to your bottom, and push up. Get the head off the mat, heels off the floor, and hold it as long as you can. That's called ponchi. And take a rest. Knees to your chest, make your back round, hug up your knees. And we're gonna do a next round. Hands under your shoulders, heels to your bottom, ready and push up. And hold the punch. Good job. Now make your back round and bend forward, stretch out. Then you're gonna go up and just hang out a little bit. You can swing from the left to the right and up and down a little bit. Just make your back round. Alright, combinations. Now we're going to combine some of those basic techniques that we did before. Here goes the first combination. We're going to start with cocorinha, flat feet on the ground, hands strong above your head, and meia lua de frente, followed by au, the cartwheel. So first cocorinha, then you bring back the leg, meia lua di frente, the kick from the outside to the inside, and the cartwheel. Remember to switch left and right each time you practice the combination. And do jing a few times in between to catch your breath if you have to. Alright, now you're gonna add a little jump to the cocorinha. Jump forward, kick and flip. Second combination. Now we're going to start with an attack. Quixada, Cocurinha with a jump, and Au to the side. Quixada, kick with the back leg from the inside to the outside, jump forward with Cocurinha, and flick to the side. Alright, add some speed to it now. Good job. Our last combination for today. You're doing great so far. Just keep on going and push it a little more. Benson. Au. Negativa. And in order to get up with the negativa, you're gonna pull back the leg and return to the jinga position. Benson to the front. Cartwheel to the side and drop in negativa. Good job, keep on going. Finish strong. All right, now to finish off for today, you're going to put everything together that we did today. And if you know any capoeira techniques, if you have been training capoeira before, just add those as well. So now you can put a chair or a bucket, if you have anything close to that size. And you're going to do the jinga in front of it. And throw your kicks right over it if you can. And combine it with any other technique that you learned today. Just free up yourself and put together all movements that you know, all capoeira moves that you have learned. Yeah, move to the left, move to the right. If you have the space, move around the object a little bit. Use the jinga. Remember all the techniques that you learned today. Maybe put a combination, one of the combinations that we just practiced.
Vamos embora, camarada. Pelo mundo afora. Pelo mundo afora.
And keep on going, be creative. Make sure you practice both sides, left and right, equally. We're almost finished. Push it a little more, a few more seconds more. Fantastic, great job.
Noch einmal.